हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एक्सरसाइज 6.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकंड। सी द गिवन थिंग। हियर गिवन थिंग इज xy mn इंटरसेक्ट एट पॉइंट O, एंगल POY इट इज गिवन 90 डिग्री एंगल। POY मींस इट इज अ परपेंडिकुलर लाइन एंड मेजर ऑफ दिस एंगल इज 90 डिग्री। रेशियो बिटवीन एंगल A एंड B इज गिवन। AS टू B इज 2S टू 3 एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ C. Now here ratio is given, and if for any terms ratio is given at that time, you have to suppose the common factor between that ratio and let that common factor be x. Let the common factor be x. If x is the common factor between A and B, then value of A means 2 into that common factor, A is equals to 2x. Value of B, 3 into that common factor, means it is 3x. Now one more thing, PO is perpendicular to xy because POY angle is equals to 90 degree, and POX and POY both the angles are in linear pair, means measure of angle POX is equals to 90 degree. From figure, angle POX plus angle POY is equals to 180 degree. Both are the linear pair angles. But here POY is 90 degree, means angle POX is equals to 180 minus 90, that is 90 degree also. Now angle A and B, these are the parts of POX. Angle POX is equals to A plus B. But angle POX is equals to 90 degree, and A is equals to 2X as per the supposition, B is equals to 3X. Means 90 is equals to 3X plus 2X, it is 5X. 90 upon 5 is equals to x. Now divide this term by 5. It is 5 ones are remaining 4, 5 8s are, means value of x is 18. And if value of A is 18, you have to find out here value of B only, because B and C are in again linear pair. Therefore, B is equals to 3 multiplied by x, means 3 multiplied by 18. And that value is 18, 3s are 54, means value of B is 54 degree. Now see, in the figure, MN is the line, XO is the ray on that line, means these two angles are in linear pair, B and C. From figure, B plus C is equals to 180 degree, but value of B is 54 degree, plus C is equals to 180, means C is equals to 180 minus 54, subtract this value, 10 minus 4 it is 6, 17 minus 5 it is 12, means that value is 126, means your answer is C is equals to 126 degree, which is the required answer. Now question number third. In this question, it is given that PQR is a triangle, and in this triangle, angle PQR is equals to angle PRQ. Means angle PQR means this angle, and angle PRQ this angle. Both the angles are equal, and you have to show that PQS and PRT both angles are equal, means you have to show that these two angles are also equal as per the given thing. Now here consider angle PQR and angle PQS. Both the angles are in linear pair. Angle PQR and angle PQS are in linear pair. And if the angles are in linear pair, their sum is 180 degree, means PQR plus angle PQS is equals to 180 degree. Give equation number 1. Similarly, consider the relation between other side angles PRQ and PRT. Also, angle PRQ and angle PRT are in linear pair, and therefore sum of these two angles is also 180 degree. PRQ plus PRT is equals to 180 degree. It is your question number 2. Now in question 1 and 2, one side is same, then you can compare that other remaining sides are also equal. From equation 1 and 2, this side is equal, and therefore you can write the LHS sides are also equal. PQR plus PQS is equals to angle PRQ plus angle PRT. These sides are also equal. But as per the given thing is PQR is equals to PRQ. Means PQR and PRQ, these two angles are equal. And if these angles are equal, you can cancel this factor as per given thing. Both the angles are equal in measure, and that's why you can cancel it, and therefore remaining terms are PQS is equals to angle